The National Security Advisor doubles down on his claim those websites are linked to the communist movement. Hermógenes Esperón insists the websites are being used by rebels to help their supposed mission to bring down the government. Esperón denies that he is red-tagging. He says he merely wants to ensure information being disseminated to the public are correct.
We have evaluated that indeed their content is not in the interest of giving true and correct information, but in the interest of propaganda and generating hatred against government. There will always be our own concern for press freedom because that is something that is dear to us. But there is also our responsibility for correct information and our aversion for misinformation. Okay lang yung criticism, pero they connect that to towards recruitment of people that may join the armed group, which is the NPA.
Esperon also stresses the move to block the websites is covered by the anti-terrorism law.
Do you know that in the implementing rules of the anti-terrorism, one of our primary taskings is to prevent and counter violent extremism? And where do you, what are the means by which you propagate hate and violent extremism? It's the platforms, social media.
A prelude to a full-blown digital martial law. That's how human rights group Karapatan describes the order of the Philippine government to block several websites with alleged links to communists. It says the move affirms concerns raised by several groups against the anti-terrorism law are legitimate. Karapatan also calls the order a blatant violation of constitutional and international human rights standards. The National Telecommunications Commission earlier blocked several websites for their alleged links to rebels. They include sites of media outlets and progressive groups. The move was done upon the request of National Security Advisor Hermógenes Esperón. The incoming chief of the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency vouches for the validity of the allegations made by Secretary Hermógenes Esperón against progressive groups and alternative media outlets. Ricardo De Leon believes the National Telecommunications Commission would not have carried out Esperón's request if it was not backed by evidence.
Hindi ka naman nagbibigay lang ng memo dyan eh. Pag gumawa ka ng request, may kasama pa natin yan ng mga documents, naka-attach lahat yan as a proof to validate your request.
De Leon also asserting it was the founder of the Communist Party of the Philippines, Joma Sison, who red-tagged some of the groups affected by the NTC order.
Sino ba yung nagsabing mag-red-tag? Eh, di ba si Joma Sison? In the tapes that we are observing, siya nagdideklara itong ganitong, yan ang front natin, ito yung ano, not the government, not the government forces. So let us start with that first premise. And we can show videos on how Joma Sison was proudly tagging these organizations. Kasi pinapalabas natin yan sa lahat ng mga estudyante natin.
The Communist Party of the Philippines, meanwhile, calls the blocking of their websites barefaced censorship. The CPP spokesperson says it's a desperate move to curb online criticism and dissent. As for the government, Acting Malacanang spokesperson Martin Andanar and Justice Undersecretary Adrian Sugay say there are legal remedies for those who feel aggrieved by the order.
For Bulatlat's managing director, the move to block their website was done without any substantial reason and basis. Len Olea also challenges Secretary Esperon to show evidence to support his claims.
We challenged Esperon to provide his basis. It is not up to us to provide evidence because the action came from him. Mm-hmm. And it is really unacceptable that these ISPs immediately implemented the order without questioning first the legality and the moral authority of the NTC to implement such blatant, illegal, brazen, and unconstitutional order.
The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, meanwhile, says this puts other news websites in danger of being blocked.
The bigger issue here is the arbitrariness of the list, no? Na parang it could be anyone, no? It just so happens that it's Bulatlat and Pinoy Weekly, no? But they could do it to anyone. The fear here is that they could cite yun nga, whatever basis they want, no? Dahil napakala ang labo ng allegations. It's not even an allegation, really. They just made a determination that these sites are affiliated or supportive of. It could start with Bulatlat and Pinoy Weekly, pero it could easily spread to other news sites. It could easily spread to other websites, is the fear.